Let everyone join, then we will start. Now to calculate the dead load on steps, you are having the formula that is 1 by 2 into R into T into 24 by 3. Again, 1 by 2 into T that is 0.25 into R that is 0.15, 150 millimeter you have taken. So again, you have to convert it in meter. It is the formula only for dead load of steps. While designing, they have designed this formula for the dead load. So, into 24 by T, that is 0.25. So, after substituting all these values, you are going to... So, after substituting all these values, you are going to get the dead load, that is 1.8. Then for floor finish, again, they are having the formula that is R plus T by T into 1. So, you have to substitute the values of R and T, that is 250 and 150, that is 0.25 plus 0.15 upon T, that is 0.25 into 1. So, you will get the floor finish, that is 1.6 kilonewton per meter square for the staircase. So, do for the dead load and the floor finish. Yes, these are the formulas designed for the. They have done the numerous trial and error methods, and after that only they have designed these formulas for the dead load and the for all the loads as well as for the floor finish. You need to remember all these formulas when you are going to solve the designing sums for the staircase. You completed? Did you got the answers? Yes, everyone completed.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, all the others are also done. Should I proceed further?
Yes, ma'am.
So here we have calculated the dead load and the floor finish. Live load you have to take it as 3 kN per meter square when you are going for to design for the staircase. Then after that you have to add all the loads till now you had calculated in the step number 1, 2, 3 and 4. So after adding all the loads you will get the value as 12.96 kN per meter square. After adding all the dead load, wet load on the west slab as well as the floor finish and the live load, you will get the total load. And after getting the total load, you need to calculate the factor load. So as and now when we calculate the factor load, you have to multiply it by 1.5. So to calculate the factor load, you will multiply the total load by 1.5. So 1.5 into total load, you will get the factor load, that is 9.5 kN per meter square. So you have to consider per meter width factor load on the flight, that is 9.5 kN per meter only. So do up till here, then we would calculate the loads on landing and mid landing in the part B. Okay, completed. Should we start with the part B? We'll complete the part B, then we will stop. Because I think another schedule is there at 1 p.m. Okay, done with the part A. Okay, so part B is to calculate the loads on landing and mid landing. For that, again, you need to calculate the self weight of the west slab. So to calculate the self weight on the west slab, you need to multiply it by 25D into 25 kN per meter cube. So D into 25D already you had calculated. So substitute the value for D, that is 0.225 into 25, you will get 5.625 kN per meter square. Then after that you have to consider the floor finish, that is 1 kN per meter square for landing and mid landing. Then again you need to assume the live load as 3 kN per meter square. Then after adding all these, you are going to get the total load, that is 9.62 kN per meter square. Again you need to calculate the factor load for landing and mid landing. सो 9.62 इंटू 1.5 आपको फैक्टर लोड मिलेगा, दैट इज 14.437 किलो न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर. अगेन यू नीड टू कंसिडर पर मीटर विड्थ, दैट इज 14.437 किलो न्यूटन पर मीटर फॉर लैंडिंग एंड मिड लैंडिंग. सो डू पार्ट बी, दैट इज लोड्स ऑन लैंडिंग एंड मिड लैंडिंग. And if any doubts, you can ask. When you will complete, let me know. Okay. So everyone understood up till here? Now we need to calculate the shear force and the bending moment. So whatever loads we are calculated up till now. So we'll continue the next part in the next lecture, because we are running short of time. So everyone understood up till here? If anyone is having any of the query, you can ask. And all the others are requested to give you attendance in the chat box.